Hi guys, Edwin here. Today another guitar accessory demo for you. So I will show you my new G7th Performance 3 Capo. And before anything else, I would like to thank G7 for sending me this Performance 3 Capo. So this is the latest model they have at the moment. Okay, I will open this now so you can see the capo inside. So it comes in a clamshell. It's very sturdy and it protects the capo inside. But some people do not like this packaging material, saying about environmental unfriendly. So probably because of the material. So now open this one. Now here it is. So basically it's about a bit similar with the previous version of G7. So you are closing this part, then when you want to open this, just press this top portion, then like this. So it's locking, then open this. So I'll try on the guitar. So just put it on top, then just press. And this one. Try the higher fret. You can see it's very easy to put from one fret to another, just one hand. Seventh. Okay, and one thing important about this Performance 3 is the new technology they employ on this capo. It's called the ART, or maybe you can see it from here, ART, or adaptive radius technology. So basically this capo can be used on various radius fretboard of the guitar. So based on what I have played, I played about 12 inch to 16 inch radius, and probably there's more, but that's the thing I have experienced. And this one can be used on that one. Probably it's more straight fretboard is also work. And the reason for that is I say moving, see this rubber, it is movable. So it has a mechanism, they calling it sliding cam, that can adjust to the radius of the fretboard. Okay, I'll show you a bit of example what does the import. Why is it important to have this technology? For example, this is the capo. This angle, this is the radius of the capo. And for example, you have a smaller radius fretboard. You can see, so you have a space on the edge. That means you need to press more on the center of the fretboard, or the string 3 and 4, and you probably have a buzz on the first and the sixth string. And the same way, if you have a flatter straight fretboard, then you have a curved capo, then you can see there's a space between the middle. So that means you need to press more on the first and the sixth string, and you have less pressure on the middle third and fourth strings. So this technology solved that problem, because it's a movable. So it adapts to the shape, and you have equal pressure on the strings. So very well done, well designed. So I'll try this now. I will include the link to their video where they show the exact mechanism of how it works, so you can see it fully well illustrated. So again, this is Edwin. Please subscribe to my channel for more of guitars, guitar videos, guitar accessories, and guitar tutorial as well. And again, this is Edwin, and thank you for watching.